What kind of reggae now? There's several kinds, you know, like, there's this shit. Yeah, my favorite groove is just 16, you know, just this shit. You could go on forever with that stuff, I mean. That's my favorite stuff. Then there's the, now, when I come up with a pattern for a new song that I've heard for the first time, I pay close attention to the bass part, any vocal that's there, meaning really paying attention to the phrasing of the vocalist, and that pretty much will dictate the time and the groove. Not only the bass part, but maybe rhythmically what the keyboards or guitar are playing. To give you an example of this, when I did the Steely Dan tune FM, it was kind of a groove basically that went like this. Boom, ch-boom, boom, ch-boom. Ch-boom, boom, 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 ch-boom, boom, ch-boom. So when I first heard that, the first thing I did was to play 16ths on the hi-hat, and it was something like this. Immediately, I didn't like that. I thought it was just a bit too busy. It made the groove just too stiff and didn't have that snaky feeling when I just heard the guys playing it by themselves. So I went to eighth notes, and it would be something like this. Now, coming up with that pattern, I want to point out that it's important. When I played just the eighth notes on the hi-hat, it wasn't like I just played them the same dynamic, you know, real stiff. I put kind of an inner lope to it. Its own inner dynamic, up and down. And that helped with the groove. That's basically what I do when I'm listening to most patterns, is think of all avenues, whether it be sixteenths, some sixteenths and eighths, or eighth notes, and then play with the inner balance, the inner dynamic of those within the bar. In keeping with the topic of the hi-hat and the dynamics within the beat, I like to practice little hi-hat exercises. That is, you know, playing eighth notes, adding in sixteenth notes, and different variations of accents and dynamics. For instance, one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. And now accent quarter notes, half notes, then I'll start adding 16th notes, and I'll turn, you know, it'll be adding a 16th note. Now, the reason I do these little exercises with the eighth notes and sixteenths and all the variations, because it's helpful for me when I'm developing drum beats for songs. And I like to practice, for instance, playing one and three on the bass drum, two and four on the snare drum, and finding out what these different figures, the different places I put sixteenth notes or eighth notes, does to the lope or the feel. For instance, now's a good time, I think, to talk about stick technique, how I hold my sticks. I use a match grip, and I hold it with the fulcrum between the first joint, my index finger, the top joint, and the meat of my thumb here. Here's my fulcrum with the sticks wrapped around. I think it's good that you investigate your technique and work on that. I do snap-ups to develop the wrist and the arm. The reason I mention that, it's really good, I think, this technique, these kind of chops are good to execute sixteenths. Now, there's two ways to play sixteenths, and it depends on the tempo, but there's the hand-to-hand method, the alternate groove, alternating stroke method of doing sixteenths. One E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a. I like the single-handed method because it's a lot smoother feel, it coming from one wrist and hand here. The reason I say so, the more you develop it, it helps with the execution of sixteenths and up-tempo things. For instance, a Mike McDonald record I keep forgetting. I tried doing the alternating stroke method of doing sixteenths, and it sounded just too stiff and staccato for me. To give you an example. Compared to let's continue with these 16th note patterns. We'll keep 16th notes going on our right hand, but this time let's develop the bass drum. Try different patterns on your bass drum, and once you come with a couple that you feel comfortable with, make two-bar phrases out of these patterns and rehearse those several times. I'll give you a couple examples. Now's a good time to get into bass drum technique. At least how I developed mine goes back to when I was a young kid, first learning to play drums. I couldn't reach my dad's pedal, so I play with my toes, basically, and the ball of my foot. And I guess you could say I dance on the pedals. And I like to slide up into my pedal when I'm doing some fast stuff. To give you an example. I slide. So that's how I go about playing my bass drum. It's the toe and ball method. Now, if we can continue with the 16th notes, I want to get into one of my favorite grooves, and that's a samba type feeling, or variations of a samba feeling. Samba feeling being this. Now what I'm playing is, it's eighth notes and sixteenths on the hi-hat. And I'm opening the hi-hat on quarter notes. And closing them on the eighth notes. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and. Now the bass drum pattern I'm going to play with the hi-hat pattern is a dotted eighth note and a sixteenth. Combining the two with the backbeats on 2 and 4, you have. The reason I like this beat is because it's a very versatile beat, at least for me, to be used in the traditional 2 and 4 like I just demonstrated, and also in a halftime like this. Now that we've gone over the 8th note and 16th note grooves, especially the latter with the samba feel, I'd like to demonstrate on a variation of a Toto tune from the last album how I came up with the beat. So what I'll ask Mike and David to do is play a variation of that tune, and I will explain what I heard and how I came up with the pattern I did. Gentlemen? So the obvious beat that you may think of coming up with that would be the traditional backbeat on 2 and 4, for example. 1, 2, 3. Now, just for fun's sake, when I always hear a tune, like I said earlier in the tape, I like to think of all the variations of that groove that would fit in to leave space and for something unique. So when I first heard the groove, I was thinking of that King Solomon's Mine type thing, where I wanted the backbeat, the beats, to be much more spread out, so the grooves to be much more halftime feeling. And it was more something like this. One, two, one, two. Guys, can we play a taste of that with me demonstrating just this simple thing? One, two, three. Now that I've established the groove of the song, it being the halftime groove with the tom-toms leading me into the third beat, it's time to fill out the rest of the bar. So if you refer to the back of the booklet, there's a snare drum solo written out. And within that snare drum solo, you'll notice there's a paradiddle starting on the second beat and a paradiddle-diddle starting on the and of three. And it should sound something like this. I'll play it on the hi-hat. Now notice how I'm accenting on one and three, the third beat being the snare drum, and there's a little ghost note. So you notice now, when I just did that exercise, I really was laying the accents on 1 and 3. The third accent will land on the snare, and there'll be a ghost note, a 16-note ghost note, right after that third beat on the snare. Now what I'll do is, after you get comfortable with the exercise, bring it over to the drums and orchestrate that pattern on the toms, the rim, cymbals, whatever. And it should sound something like this. 1, 2, 3. Next, I'd like to get into the shuffle groove. That is the groove derived from triplets. And what I'd like to start off with, we'll start with our eighth note triplet groove. This is the kind of groove you can hear in Sly and the Family Stone's Hot Fun in the Summertime, which I stole from to get my beat for Hold the Line. And that is triplets being, I'll demonstrate on the hi-hat, 1-ta-ta, 2-ta-ta, 3-ta-ta, 4-ta-ta. Now, just keeping triplets, what I'm going to do is, on the bass drum, I'm going to play a pattern hitting the bass drum on the downbeat of 1 and on the last triplet of the second beat. And I'm going to hit snare drum on 2 and 4. So with the guys, what I'm going to do is we're going to play, it's actually like a shuffle Charleston figure. And I'm going to play different variations, accenting the hi-hat differently, maybe opening the hi-hat on the last triplet of the fourth beat and closing it on 1, and just messing around with different accents, variations of this groove. An example. 1, 2, 3. Next, we're going to get into the shuffle groove, and that is the first and last note of the triplet on the first beat, the first and last note of the triplet on the second, the first and last note of the triplet on the third, and the first and last note of the triplet on the fourth. Something like this. 1-ta-ta, 2-ta-ta, 3-ta-ta, 4-ta-ta, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to play a backbeats on the snare drum on 2 and 4, and the bass drum, I'm going to play the first and last note of the triplet on the first beat, and the last note of the triplet on the second beat. The first and last triplet of the third beat, and the last note of the triplet on the fourth beat. Something like this. Now you'll notice what I like to do is on the backbeats, you'll hear a ghost note after each backbeat. A ghost eighth note triplet beat there, like this. Now this is the kind of beat and the variations of this beat that I used on like Lido Shuffle and Black Friday and whatnot. So maybe we can play a taste of a little up-tempo shuffle groove for you here. 1, 2, 1, 2. We'll be right back. That's the shuffle, one version. Another version is playing with the left hand what you're playing with your right hand. That is the first beat and the last beat of the triplet of beats 1, 2, 3, and 4. And that would sound something like this. Now you'll notice I'm not making the accents, the beats even in dynamics with the left hand, because I want the 2 and 4 to land real nice, sounding like this again. So that's the kind of groove you hear sometimes. What's the Marvin Gaye tune, Trouble Man? Real nice, bluesy, sexy type things. Something like this. Let's play a little bit. 1, 2, 3. All right, next I'd like to get into the halftime shuffle groove. This groove is one of my favorites. Some of my favorite drummers, I love hearing them play this kind of groove. I used the halftime shuffle groove on the tune Rosanna, the Toto cut. And I've been asked about that beat a lot, so I'd like to try to explain that beat the best of my ability right now, get it clear. I stole that beat from listening to two records. One was Home at Last, and Babylon Sisters, which is Bernard Purdy, Steely Dan Records. Another is the John Bonham on Fool in the Rain, a Led Zeppelin tune. The Bernard Purdy thing, I like to call it the Bernard Purdy halftime shuffle, is basically this. The John Bonham beat that I copied from Fool in the Rain was something like this. Putting those two beats together, I came up with my own little kind of hybrid. For Rosanna, I added the Bo Diddley figure. It's a shuffle Bo Diddley figure, basically. And putting them together, this is what it came up with. All right, let me break this beat down for you. On the hi-hat, I'm playing the first and last note of the triplet on each beat. With the left hand, I'm going to ghost the second note of each triplet on each beat, something like this. One, one, one. Now I'm going to add the backbeat on the third beat on the snare drum, and I'm going to ghost the second note of the third triplet, something like this. Now I'm going to add the Bo Diddley shuffle bass drum figure. Bonk. And altogether, it should be something like this. That's the basic groove. Now, you can do things like play quarter notes on the hi-hat like Bernard do to get a different kind of lope out of it. And that would sound like this. Okay, now I'm going to play a little bit of this groove with the band so that you can play along. 1, 2, we'll be right back. Okay, and another shuffle groove that I like to play is one that for me comes from the jazz cymbal beat, which is the one ta ta two ta ta three ta ta four ta ta one ta ta two ta ta three ta ta four ta ta one ta ta two ta ta three ta ta four. Now, I would recommend listening to some jazz albums and playing along just with your right hand. And build up. Because you could take the jazz beat and apply it to some contemporary nice grooves, thusly. And it would sound something like this. And you can mess with the hi-hat. So I'm going to play a little bit of that with the rhythm section and check it out. One, two, three. Another halftime groove you can do is, earlier I showed you the cymbal beat, the jazz cymbal beat, and how that applied to a shuffle with the backbeats. We'll do the same beat with the hi-hat, except now put the snare drum on the third beat. Something like this. And now we'll demonstrate it with the rhythm section. One, two, three. Alright, in closing, I'd like to re-emphasize what I said earlier, and that is you should work on your technique, your fundamental rudiments, and really listen to as many records as possible so you can hear all sorts of grooves, all sorts of different drummers, and their interpretations of those grooves, and play as much as possible. I would also like to thank Richie Onori and Joe Porcaro for their technical assistance, Bill Schnee for engineering, and Mike Porcaro and David Garfield for being in the rhythm section. And we'd like to close with a Garfield composition called Creature Stomp. Oh,
Thank you. how you really play that, the ghost notes.
Yeah, somebody said they saw Harvey Mason was at a thing and told everybody I overdubbed the ghost notes. No, and then a drummer, he goes, no, a drummer can't physically play that. That whole beat, though, what's amazing is that I feel uncomfortable when people ask me about this beat, because it's nothing, it's like if I invented this beat to Rosanna. And it's not the case. I mean, I don't know how many times I've told people that's mainly Bernard Purdy has that group down better than anybody. And then I would hear from John Bonham used to do it, man, all the time. Different things, but especially with the Greystone things. And I mean, there was a record that we had, the group Toto had, our second album is a song called Mama. And it was,
sometimes, yeah, you mean about
up, I wouldn't have done those. But like on a Lido shuffle, a Boss thing or something.
So, here we go. Ready, cowboy? Just about? You want to do it? Done! My baby. Shot me down! Hey! Oh, my goodness! Woo! Oh! Woo! Thank you. Thank you very much. Jeff Porcaro on drums, ladies and gentlemen. Jeff Porcaro on drums.